Hello, in this video today, I'm going to be showing you how you can basically open up your ComfyUI install to the world. So basically, if you want to share ComfyUI with a friend for application testing, whatever it is, it's a quick and easy way to kind of create that connection between a local host instance and a public facing URL that anyone can access. And you can password protect it as well too. But for this, I'm going to be using pingy.io. I understand there's other options available. I find this one to be super easy to use, and I just wanted to kind of walk you through it. Now, to set up this tunnel, it's super easy. They have a really nice document on their site. I'll link to it in the description. But basically, you just need this command line, and then just to paste it into your terminal after you create an account, of course. So if I pop over to my Windows machine here, you can see I have ComfyUI running on port 8188, which is the standard port that it boots up on. And I'm going to paste in that command. Now, I've noticed that whenever trying to start this up, sometimes it doesn't work perfectly with just the default localhost. I tried editing my host file on the Windows machine. But one surefire way that I found that works fairly well is if I just go to the start here and put in -4 to force an IPv4 connection. Or if I change localhost to 127.0.0.1, that will always work. So I'm just going to set that. I will not be putting in the password at least just for this demonstration, but I would recommend that in general. And there's our link. So now I'm going to copy that link and hop over to the Macintosh here and paste in that link and connect to it. So you'll get this little notice screen here to make sure that you trust it. All right, so now we're connected to ComfyUI over on that Windows machine. I'm going to just change out this model just for demonstration and put in Starry Night by Vincent van Gogh. And then fire that off. And if I pop over to the Windows machine, we can see that that prompt just executed. We can see the requests going through the pingy.io tunnel there. And then here is our output that was just remotely created. So that's it. If you have any questions, drop it in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to consider hitting the like and subscribe.